Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault, but keep it between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to Jesus Christ.
You hear the kids stirring. You open your eyes as you're lying in bed, and you're thinking, it can't be morning already. It's Sunday. I have to get up and get dressed and get the kids dressed. So you wash up. You get the kids washed up. You throw the paper inside, and you try to get the kids from killing each other over who gets to the comics first. You get some breakfast coffee. You get some coffee in yourself, and you get some cereal in the kids. And you look at the clock. Oh my God, it's 8:45 already. Get the kids in the car. We've got to go. So you drive down the street, and you seem to be one of the few families that are stirring. Everyone else is planning to have a relaxing breakfast. It hits you. We are in a minority on our block. We are one of the few families that goes to church on Sunday morning. On another trip, five of you make the trip to corporate headquarters in Phoenix. The second night, four of the others found dates. Three are married, but their view is what their spouses know or don't know won't hurt them. So you go to a movie alone, and it's clear to you, I'm in the minority. Perhaps some of these situations or others like that have occurred in your life. Perhaps they occur frequently. Perhaps you have wondered, why am I in the minority? Why am I getting up early on Sunday when the rest are sleeping in? Why am I the one who is alone at the movie while everyone else is out having a good time? When questions like this disturb us, we have to remember, Jesus never promised us that we would be in the majority. He just promised us that he would be with us always. The Gospel of Matthew today revolves around this very theme. Jesus is with us, even if we see just a small, insignificant number. We have the concluding words of today's Gospel. For where two or three are gathered in my name, I am in the midst of them. We are, and will always be, in the minority as Christians. But Jesus Christ never promised us that we would be in the majority. He just promised us that he would be with us always.